So that is just a minute. Yeah. So we're going to discuss about. Is it clear now? Yeah. So we're going to discuss about urinary bladder. Okay. The anatomy of urinary bladder. So the difference between what we were discussing till today, 3-4 days, and what we are going to discuss today is that urinary bladder, it's a pelvic organ, okay, pelvic organ. It is situated in the pelvis. So now, then what is pelvis? Question is, what is pelvis? Okay, what is pelvis? How abdomen is different from pelvis? This is the question for you guys. Okay, how abdomen, you should read and tell me. It's very basic. Like as we discussed that, thorax and abdomen are differentiated by what? The thoraco-abdominal diaphragm. Now the question is, how abdomen and pelvis are differentiated? Okay, you need to go, or someone wants to join. Yeah. So you need to read and tell me, and or read it for your knowledge, even if you don't want to tell me that, how you differentiate between abdomen and pelvis. What is the feature? Okay. So, one hint I can give you is that most of the abdominal contents are inside the peritoneum. They are inside the peritoneum. Okay. There are many which are not. For example, yes, correct, pancreas and, yeah, which is separated by, okay. So, that is a different story. But then, with respect to pelvis, one thing is common, they are extraperitoneal, okay. They are extraperitoneal. The second thing is that, okay, you're going to read me and tell me, okay. Otherwise, you're not going to understand, okay, what is abdominal pelvis. So, one rough idea I will give you. See, you say that the two hip bones, they will join, okay, this way. I am not drawing the correct diagram, but you understand. This is the hip bone. This is what, yeah, the foramen. And so this way behind you have the sacrum. Okay, sacrum. Okay, this way, the sacral alley. So this cavity what forms is the human pelvis. Okay, human pelvis. And all organs in this human pelvis are called as pelvic organs. So urinary bladder lies in this pelvis, so it is called as the pelvic bladder. So it is called as the it is the pelvic organ. Okay, urinary bladder. Again, it's a muscular bag. Oh, it is same muscular bag. Its dimensions, lido. Okay, all that is theoretical. Not much to be discussed on that. So one important thing which I want to highlight, which they have mentioned in the textbook also, is about the sphincters of the urinary bladder. I mean, it's an interesting point. They can ask you in the MCQ question as a question of except. Okay. So, in that you can have the question is that the sphincter, the external urethral sphincter and the internal urethral sphincter. Now, external urethral sphincter is not present at the distal end of the urethra. It is present at the proximal end. So, the sphincter is present on the proximal side, in the proximal end, and not in the distal end like that of the stomach, especially, and the other parts of the body. For example, you can also consider the anal canal. We could have discussed anal canal. It's a short question. It's a long question. There's a space around the anal canal. Okay. There's a space around the anal canal, and they ask a short note on that. Okay, so that is the rectal fossa. Rectal fossa. Okay, so fossa around the rectum, they are asked as a short note question. So anorectal fossa is also the same thing. It is continuation of the rectal fossa. So, anal canal ka jo sphincter hai and stomach ka jo sphincter hai aur baki sphincters which are there in the body, their sphincters are present distally if you see the anatomy. If possible, if time permits, one day we will discuss about anal canal also. And stomach already we have seen. If you see the cardiac and if you see the pyloric sphincter, it is present distally in the stomach, not proximally. So this was about sphincter. This is an MCQ question they may raise before you guys. Following are a very important or easy MCQ which they can ask is, following are the structures which are in the pelvis except. So this is a very, childish question. You may not entertain. Okay. So today I bought a small paper model for you guys. See this. Can you see this? Yes. Now see, very simple. In the viva, when you are given the urinary bladder and you are asked to hold it in the proper anatomical position, so it is very simple. Aise haath jod ke khade ho jao. Not like this, this way. Okay. You have to bend a bit in front like this. I'll show you from the side. See this way. Okay, this way. And this way you should be. Matlab this is the correct thoda sa aise. Yeah, this one. So what you are having? You're having this border, you're having lower border this way, this border. Okay, you're having these two surfaces which you have mentioned like this. So they are inferolateral. Now, in this case, I am holding my own urinary bladder. Remember this. You are going to hold your own urinary bladder like this when you put up this position. Okay, so you are removed your urinary bladder and you hold it like this. Imagine it like that. So what is there? This is the inferior surface. I am standing like this. I am holding it like this. So this is the inferior surface on the lateral aspect. So inferolateral aspect. So this is the surface. So inferolateral surface. Simple. Okay. Inferolateral surface. So how is the model? This way. It is packed from above. Okay. For you to understand, I kept it open. Okay. Can you see this hole? Can you see this hole inside? See. Can you see this? See this one? Yeah, this hole. So this hole, pass the pen, okay? This hole is the continuation for the urethra. Continuation for the urethra. So you're going to hold it this way. So now, you're holding it this way. It's a bit in front, like this, tilted. So what all it is having, you can easily tell me. See, one is superior surface. Ye upar band rehta hai, okay? Purposefully, I have kept it open for you to understand. A diagram in the textbook also has been given. But it is just this way. So you cannot see these surfaces. But I put a three-dimensional model of paper for you to understand. So see, this is the superior surface. This is the posterior surface, which is also known as the base. Base. Okay, ye base aisa hai. Ye aisa urinary bladder aisa baitha hai. So this is the base behind. Okay, this is the superior surface. This is the inferolateral surface for the right side. Inferolateral surface for the left side. Okay, so how many surfaces? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Otherwise, you can say there are 3 surfaces and 1 base. Okay, then you have the apex. This is the apex. Okay, this is the apex. Okay, this is the apex. And this is the neck. This is the neck. And this is the continuation of urethra here. This is the neck. Okay, and continuation of urethra. Like this. Urethra. So, you are getting the external, features, the size, the shape, the position. I will tell you when it comes to relation. So an empty bladder is like this in shape, that is tetrahedral. So jab usme urine bhar jayega, to what will happen? This will get ovoid in shape. See this, like this, ovoid in shape. See this, ovoid in shape. Okay, ovoid in shape. Okay, ovoid in shape. Otherwise, when it is empty or semi-filled, it is this way. Okay, 500 ml is the rough capacity, and beyond then the problem starts. Okay, so this is C, the tetrahedral shape. Can you see? If you keep it like this, it looks like a pyramid, but of uneven sizes. 1, 2, 3, 3 side ka pyramid like this. So I hope I am able to make you imagine the dimensions and the shape of the and the sides of the urinary bladder. It's very simple. You just have to imagine it like this. So I repeat, there is one base, one superior surface, two inferolateral. You niche hai na, inferior side mein. Aisa face kar raha hai, inferior side, not the superior side. So inferior side, inferolateral surfaces on right and left each, and this is the apex, and this is the neck. Now, one most important thing when you write in the, yesterday some people raised the question, what we should write in the LAQ. Now, usually they give you the headlines to write in the LAQ, yet I will mention those important headlines and points. Okay, now when it comes to LAQ, see, I have been telling this since the beginning. More the diagrams, equally proportional to number of marks. So write less. Don't write big answers. No one has time to read. Show it by diagrams. So simply show it by, I'll show you how to draw this diagram. Okay, what I want to say. So this is very simple. Now LAQ, they will ask you about external features. You have first you have to give an intro. What you have to give about, it's a muscular bag, it is present in the pelvis and it's outside the peritoneal bag, that is the peritoneum. And it's a muscular bag of around capacity 500 ml to 500 to 600 ml and it has the sphincter. It is an exceptionally thing. I mean, if you write such detailed points, examiner aap pe fida ho jayega for sure. So it has the proximal end of the sphincters. And then you come to the external features, you say that it is what all shape and all it is having. And then you write about this and then when it gets filled, it becomes overt this way. And now one important thing is it's about the ligaments. Okay, this we will discuss more in detail when we are talking about the relations of the urinary bladder. But there is one ligament which you have to mention here in the external features because it's related to the apex. Okay. So this apex is connected to the umbilicus in the fetal period of the developing fetus inside the womb of the mother, and it is connected by a urancus. Urancus is like a tube connecting the apex of the urinary bladder and the umbilicus. And the umbilicus that is present on the abdomen, in the umbilical quadrant of your abdomen. So this is a connection within the fetal period. So it gets obliterated. Obliterated matlab kya? Sikur jata hai. It becomes stenosed. Rather than stenosed, obliterated in the sense you might understand. There is no connection. It's all filled up. Okay, it's all filled up. So that obliteration, that urancus gets obliterated and it is nothing but the ligament, which is called as the, yes, can anyone tell me, it is the median umbilical ligament. Median. Yeah, we saw the difference of the names in the diaphragm also. Jo beech mein connect hota hai, diaphragm ka yaad hai kya? Ye wala diagram. This ye aisa. So this was the median ligament. This is the medial ligament and this is the lateral ligament, arcuate ligament. So the question we had discussed, how many arcuate ligaments are there? Okay, 7 or 8. Again, I asked the question that day. I think I'd made a mistake. I don't remember. I think it's 7. 7 is the number. You find it out again. Okay. So this is the median umbilical. Umbilical, kyun umbilicus se connected hai, isliye umbilical ligament. It is connecting the. It is not. So you would have seen the cases where this remains patent, the urancus doesn't get obliterated and form a ligament, it remains patent, and that urine dribbles outside this from the umbilicus. Okay, this is one of the applied anatomy as well. Very rare cases, but yet you can find it. Okay, one more thing, that in the fetal period, because we are learning gynecology, obstetrics and pediatrics, one thing I would like to tell you, in the fetal life, what happens, the urine which is formed, actually it is not the urine, it is the lichen, as you know. And the baby leaves out the lichen, okay, this way, and then it sucks and it drinks its own lichen. Okay, it drinks its own lichen. So this happens, and so this patency is there in the fetal life. Okay, baby drinks its own lichen. The lichen has its urine and all other fluids. And it is there. So it drinks almost 1 to 1.2 liters of lichen per day. I think 1.1 liters or 800 ml something. So it drinks this much lichen every day. This is another topic, that what are the factors for secretion of the lichen and all that. But I'll not go in details. Now I'll bring you, see, the textbook gives you one diagram. I'll share with you that diagram. Just a minute. Yeah, I have taken that diagram for you. It takes a lot of time to draw the diagram, so I decided that I'll directly share the textbook diagrams for you guys. Oh, where's the diagram? Oh, yeah, just a moment. No, yeah, 1 minute. Okay, one important, before we, I'll share the diagram later, wait. So see this, yeah, come back to me, I'll hurry up a bit, we are going slow. Yeah, see this. So shape you got, this is how it is, okay. So ye samajh mein aa raha hai, ye aisa, ye aisa, ye aisa. This is the apex and here you have the neck. This is the neck apex. Abhi, it is in the anterior part of the body, right? So now you need to imagine that how it is. See, in females it is different, in males it is different. How? I mean, urinary bladder is not different. What is different is that there is extra organ, that is uterus, in the females. So I'll draw it for you. This is a very important diagram which you will, I mean, it will be useful to you at many places. See, this is the pubic symphysis, your landmark. Okay, this is the pubic symphysis. Please mute your mics. Yeah. See, this is the pubic symphysis. Okay, this is the pubic symphysis. Now, perineal membrane. Day before yesterday, we were discussing about the number of diaphragms, and you had one urogenital diaphragm, you had the pelvic diaphragm. And what is pelvic diaphragm? Perineal membrane, you go and read. It's another a big topic, an LAQ question. Pelvic diaphragm, how many muscles, what all form, etc., etc., etc. So this is the pelvic diaphragm. Ye pelvic diaphragm ki idhar niche tumko urethra ka continuation milega. Yaha hai pelvic body. This, what is, see, this is very important. I will tell you the applied aspect. It is actually a part of uterus, the pelvic body. The point, applied anatomy, but I will tell you, pelvic body, no, sorry, perineal body. It is very important. This carries a lot of importance in obstetrics. Okay, I'll tell you the applied later on. Okay, just remind me. Yeah, this is the perineal membrane. So I will label it for you. Oh, it was not visible to you, sorry. Yeah, see this, this is the pubic symphysis. Okay, this is landmark for you. Okay. This is the perineal membrane. Perineal membrane. Pelvic diaphragm. Kya rehta hai? Ja ke padho. Okay, it's a big question, important question. And this is the perineal body. Perineal body actually kya hai balu mein kya? Ye bahut sare muscle aake ek saath hai na, udhar hi ja ke jud jate. That is called as a perineal body. So you can imagine fibers are coming from this direction, all the directions, and they're forming a strong structure. And that is nothing but the perineal body. And it gives a lot of support to the perineal membrane and otherwise also. Otherwise, if you would have sneezed, if you would have coughed, all your organs of the pelvis would have come down, especially in the females or in the males as well. There would have been rectal prolapse. Prolapse matlab kya? I will again tell you. So, see, prolapse matlab kya? Wo organ bahar aa jata hai. Matlab, suppose, abhi, okay, first we will discuss this diagram. Hum bhatak rahe. So, see this. This is the bladder. तो ये उसका बेस है, ये सुपीरियर सरफेस है, ये इंफीरियर लैटरल, ये इंफीरियर बॉर्डर है और ये इंफीरियर लैटरल सरफेस, ऐसा दिस वे. ओके, सो नाउ एंड दिस इज योर रेक्टम. ओके, दिस इज योर रेक्टम बिहाइंड. दिस इज आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट मेल्स. दिस इज आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट मेल्स. सो व्हाट यू कैन सी दिस वे, सी दिस, दिस इज द रेक्टम. दिस आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट मेल्स, एज आई मेंशन टू यू. दिस इज योर यूरिनरी ब्लैडर. And around the urinary bladder, as you know, just at the neck and below, you have the prostate gland. Yeah, prostatic gland. So this is the prostate gland. Now, prostate gland hai, to abhi, ye dekho, this one. So peritoneal fold is there, like this. Okay, peritoneal fold is there. That fold is known as, see, it is between what? Anatomy is easy. You don't have to mug up names. Everything is there itself. This is the rectum. And uterus को, ये urinary bladder को हम क्या बोलते हैं, vessa को. I told you day before yesterday, vessa को, when we were yesterday only, when we were talking about the vessa को ureteric reflux in that X-ray, in the end when we were discussing the applied anatomy, at that time I told you that urinary bladder, it is called as vessa को. So recto vessical pouch, simple, recto vessical pouch, very simple. Okay, recto vessical pouch. जे ऑर्गन आहे त्याच्याशीच रिलेटेड नाव असतं, वेगळं काहीही नसतं. आता रेक्टो वसायकल पाउच आहे आणि हे पाउच असं, ऍक्च्युली इट्स लाईक दिस, ऍक्च्युली इट इज लाईक दिस. ओके, रेक्टो वसायकल पाउच. एंड दिस रेक्टोवेसिकल पाउच के जो इधर जो फेशिया है, दैट फेशिया फॉर्म्स अ स्ट्रक्चर विच इज कॉल्ड एज रेक्टोवेसिकल. ओके, आई विल लेबल इट हियर रेक्टोवेसिकल फेशिया ऑफ द नेम इज वेरी सिंपल एंड अ बिट लेंथी, डेनोन विलियर्स. आई एम नॉट मेकिंग मिस्टेक इन द स्पेलिंग. See, if you write this name, rectovesical fascia of Denwyers, and if you draw this diagram when you are talking about the urinary bladder, when you are talking about the prostate, the examiner will definitely give you good marks for sure. Okay, this is an important point. Okay, I mentioned it. This is an important point. And I have already told you the applied it. Now, perineal body, I will tell you, it plays a great role in avoiding the prolapse of the uterus during parturition of the baby. You know, the uterus can come out like this. Andar se bahar aa sakta hai. Why? Because the female is putting up a lot of pressure, she is in labor, and if there is no support below, the uterus will damn sure prolapse, and this does not happen because of the perineal body. So if there is a tear, because perineal body is nothing but a muscular structure, okay, all the muscles are coming and combining there and forming a perineal body. So if there is tear in the perineal body, the damn sure thing what happens is that the uterus gets prolapsed. Uterus is a direct, it gets eroded outside, and it's not a simple condition. Okay, it's not a simple condition. So perineal body is of great support. So this is about the males. Now what additional gets added in the females is same. You will draw you should draw like this. Okay, aisa ek diagonal line banayega. Okay, so this is, you have to draw three openings. So one is for the uterus. Second is for the urinary bladder. Actually, first is for urinary bladder. सबसे आगे रहता है. ये pubic symphysis है और urinary bladder में कितना 2 centimeter का space रहता है. I will tell you. I have one diagram for that. I will tell you. These are the two diagrams which I brought. I have taken from other chapter as well as from other books. And see, it is. I am making things easy for you. It really took time for me to gather all the things because no one tells you कि ये diagram इधर से लो. So this is the urinary bladder or the okay, this I am talking about the females. What is extra? We were discussing. That is the uterus. Now, uterus, you know, it's everted and whatnot. Aisa hai. Okay. It thoda proportional nahi hoga diagram, but you kindly consider. I know you guys are very, and this is your rectum. Okay. Aada he ka hai ithe pubic symphysis, apna landmark. Okay. So, this is the pubic symphysis. Please mute, someone has put up the voice on. Arre yaar, disturbs others. Oh, okay. So see, this is the pubic symphysis and this is your urinary bladder. Okay, so this is your urethral opening. In the females, it is shorter, 4 centimeters, we had discussed day before yesterday. This is the uterus and this is your rectum. Now, there is a pouch. Actually, I made a mistake. I bahut nazdik draw kar diya. No issues. Now, as usual, ithe kutla pouch hota? Vesico-rectal or recto-vesical pouch. Because it was present between the rectum and the urinary bladder. Now, the pouch is present between urinary bladder and the uterus. So, it is known as the utero-vesical pouch. Or you can also call vesico-uterine pouch. Okay, vesico, I'll show that in green color. Okay, because it's a peritoneal fold, aisa. And this also again here. Okay, see, so this is what the pouch between the uterus, that is vesico uterine pouch, and this is recto. आता यूटेरस चा मध्ये रेक्टो यूटेराइन पाउच विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज पाउच ऑफ डगलस. ओके, पाउच ऑफ डगलस. आता हा नाव पण खूप महत्वाचा आहे. जसं आपण पाहिलं मॉर्गॅग्नी, कॉलम्स ऑफ मॉर्गॅग्नी असतात, साइनस ऑफ मॉर्गॅग्नी असतात, लाईन्स ऑफ मॉर्गॅग्नी असतात. ओके, सो लाईक दॅट यू हॅव दिस ऑल्सो रेक्टो यूटेराइन पाउच ऑफ डगलस. डगलस किवी नेम्स यू हॅव टू फाइंड. ओके, देर इज वन बॅग ऑफ डगलस. यू शुड टेल मी, क्वेश्चन फॉर यू इज where you use bag of Douglas. Okay, where do you use the bag of Douglas? Okay, you need to tell me about that. Okay, bag of Douglas. So come back to this discussion. So in the females, what you have, the two pouches, rectouterine pouch and vasculoterine. Now how I am drawing, female is standing and I have taken a sagittal section. सिर के बीच में से काटा है तो तुमको ऐसा व्यू दिखेगा. सिमिलरली मैन स्टैंडिंग एंड यू टेकन अ सजाइटल सेक्शन. प्लीज म्यूट योर वॉइस. समवन इज या सो व्हाट डू यू सी? वसाइको यूटराइन पाउच इज योर एंड रेक्टो यूटराइन पाउच ऑफ डगलस. दिस एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन. फ्लूइड फिल्स एस्पेशली ड्यूरिंग व्हेन देयर इज यू नो असाइटिस इन द पेशेंट. यू मे फाइंड the fluid in the pouch of Douglas, and there is a method to assess this in medicine. Now the thing is, what are these pouches? These are actually peritoneal folds. Understanding? These are actually the peritoneal folds. So in peritoneum, what happens when the ascites is happening? The fluid accumulates in the peritoneal sac. So the peritoneal sac is pouch. Ahe, pure continuation ahe. Tyamule fluid gets accumulated here in ascites, in massive ascites usually. So this is what this. These are the two important diagrams which you can use at many places. I'll just take a photograph of them so that I can post them on the group for you guys. Okay, you can also take a screenshot if you want. Okay, now coming back to urinary bladder, we saw these relations. Okay, urinary bladder ke piche kya hai, aage kya hai. One diagram I have for you guys by which I can explain you. Kidhar gaya gallery mein? Yeah, just a minute. Yeah, see this. The things which I was telling you just now. See this. So, this one. Yeah. So this is the fascia of Dunnan-Willers. Fascia of Dunnan-Willers, Denon-Willers. Okay, ejaculatory duct behind the on the posterior aspect. See the. I have written the dimensions here. See, this is 2 centimeters. So what is there? Retropubic fat. Retro manje maage. Pubic manje kaya? Pubic symphysis. A pubic symphysis. Okay. Pubic bone karun kaya tayar hota? Pubic symphysis form hota dogancha madhe. Doni pubic hecha madhe. And retropubic fat is there. Okay. Again, what is the role? If the bladder is a soft tissue, pubic symphysis is a bone. So again, if there is friction and all there may be possibility of the wear and tear of the urinary bladder. So this is the apex. Again, which kind of view this is? You are viewing, see, this is the posterior aspect. This is the anterior aspect. This is the superior aspect. And this is the inferior aspect. So, tumhi kaya paata hai? Tum manchala uba kele and you have cut it sagittally. See, this is the sagittal section. And what is happening? Sagittal section. Again, see, this is the perineal body. Perineal body. This is the perineal membrane. Okay, this is the perineal membrane. This is the perineal body. You please read today about perineal membrane, the pelvic diaphragm. Okay, so between the rectum and the prostate or here the urethra, this is 4 centimeters of gap. And rectovesical pouch of rectovesical pouch of Douglas. Okay, I think this labeling is incorrect. Just leave this. Okay, I'm not sure if it is. Pouch of Douglas in males also. Just kindly confirm, I'm not sure. But at least it is the rectovesical pouch because it is present between the rectum and the vesico, that is the urinary bladder. So, I think I have cleared. So, you are seeing the person from the left side. Ye person ka aage peeche. Okay, I'll take one screenshot of this photograph also so they can post it in the group. Okay, so I think I have cleared this diagram and the concept for you guys. Now, come back to, yeah, where it is? Yeah, zoom. So I have another photograph for you, just a minute. It is showing you the posterior relations of the urinary bladder. Yeah, this one. See this. So see this. Here what you can see, I'll use the pen. See, upper part of the base of the peritoneum. You remove the posterior part, you remove the vertebral column, sacrum, and then you are viewing this. You remove the rectum and you are viewing this. Now see that upper part of the base of the covered, it is covered with the peritoneum. So as I told you in the beginning, it's an extra peritoneal structure. Peritoneum upper hai, to iske piche agar peritoneum pouch bana raha hai, to iske upper peritoneum will have something, some part of it, and that is the upper part of the base. Base is flat, as we have seen in the beginning of the dimensions of the and the shape of the urinary bladder. Okay, so ductus deferens, they come from behind and they enter they join the urethra, and then they at the ejaculatory duct, and how it is, you know. So we're not discussing about vas deferens, the ductus deferens. We're talking about urinary bladder, but it is in the posterior relation. You see the seminal vesicle and its duct, okay, and the urethra. So prostate, from posterior aspect, it is present. So this is the posterior view. It's simple. Ureter also joined from the posterior aspect in the base, that is the posterior surface of the urinary bladder. One important thing which you need to remember is that the triangular area, I think this is different. The triangular area is present in the interior of the, that is a different concept. Okay, fine. So I think you are well versed with this. And also that there is one statement in the textbook that the neck of the person, the neck of the, what do you call, the urinary bladder, not the person. Okay. See, this neck is the most fixed part. Why it is fixed part? Because iske aajubaju mein kya prostate hai. Prostate is hard. Prostate is very hard. Okay, we have some message from the chat box. Anyone wants to ask some question? Yeah, that is what I am saying. It's extraperitoneal. Urinary bladder is extraperitoneal. Peritoneum ka fold uske piche se ja raha hai, to uske upar bhi kuch rahega na. See, this is like this. Okay, this is the peritoneum. Ye aise aaya, aise piche gaya, pouch banaya, aur idhar piche rectum hai. This is the posterior aspect, this is the base. Okay. So, neck is the most fixed part. Okay, most fixed part, especially in males. The prostate is a bony structure. So, you know, when you are removing the urinary bladder from the cadaver, when you are doing the dissection of the cadaver, the urinary bladder at that time, you separate it by this bony landmark, by bony like landmark of the prostate, because it is very hard. Okay, it is very much hard. Okay, so I have one statement from the textbook which can be asked as the MCQ, that the triangular area between the two different ducts is separated from the rectum by the rectovesicular fascia of Denen Villiers. So what we discussed this, okay, and what we saw the diagram just now, yeah, it was the triangular area, what I was telling you just now, it is, I was right there. See, I'll show you, see this diagram, yeah, you see this, I'll show you in blue color, or I'll show it in green color. See, this is the triangular area, this is the triangular area, or either aajubaju mein kya hai, aajubaju mein, see this. See, this is the ductus deferens. Yes, this one. This is the ductus deferens. So what you see, this triangular area is separated by what? It is separated by what? See, this is a peritoneum which is coming down. Okay, on the upper part of the urinary bladder, it is there. When it is coming behind, it is forming the pouch, rectovesical pouch, the picture rectum, because we are seeing the posterior view. Hope you are getting and imagining what I want to say. And then, so below it, what it was having? As I told you, fascia. Which fascia? Denen Villiers fascia. So this Denen Villiers fascia is present here. Denen Villiers fascia, and it separates the rectum and this triangular area, as well as the two ductus deferens. Getting? So this this is the Denen Villiers fascia here. This will form the pouch here behind. It will come like this and form the pouch with a piche urinary bladder. I am not able to show it in the three-dimensional condition, but I hope you understand. Okay. So coming back to this. Yeah. So continuing the discussion. Now come back to the most important point. So we discuss about the relations. Okay. We discuss about the relations. In males, the superior surface is completely covered by the peritoneum, as we discussed just now. And in females, peritoneum, again, it covers the greater surface, except for a small area
near the posterior border, which is related to the supravaginal part of the uterine cervix. So as we discussed, that